So this is my latest project that I'm weaving. It's going to be a scarf or kind of a shawl, I guess, since it's pretty wide. But as you can see, it's not like a regular scarf. There's holes in it. And when you make holes on purpose, it can be pretty cool. This is just a basic grid thing. I have 20 ends per little block thing. And I'm doing 26 picks for every block because I'm so for some reason incapable of beading lightly enough to make it square. I'm using this regular like lace weight knitting yarn. I got it from knitpicks.com because don't really have very much actual weaving yarn. I was sort of concerned about how well it would hold up to going through the heddles and everything, but it's doing very well. And I really like how it's coming out. And each little block is 2-inch square, and then I have 1-inch gaps. And I'm using these pieces of paper, or this one piece of paper, to make the blocks, or make the gaps. It's really easy, and it's really fast too, because I guess that's what happens when you're moving forward 3 inches for every 2 inches you weave. But yeah, I just started it yesterday. I started the warping and everything, and I'm almost gonna be done in a half an hour. But I wanted to show you. This is like just the second bobbin I've been using. Just kind of nice. And I have to be quiet now because I have to count picks. Incidentally, does anyone have any tips for keeping a solid shed floor without keeping the entire warp under horrendous tension? Because I am having trouble with that. To have it pretty tight. See, very fast. That's one block, 28 picks. Did I say 26 before? I meant to say 28. That's one block. And I'll just put the shuttle over there and then pull out the piece of paper that was down here. Because once you have another block built up, you don't need it. And then I'll open up the shed that I just left down, the shed that this most recent pick went through, and I'll put the paper back through. Gonna be a 1-inch gap, and then I have to advance the warp because it goes pretty fast. Tighten it up. And then start going again. And then switch sheds. And start all over again. And that's really all there is to it. I think if I do this again, I might use a thicker yarn, or if I eventually get a finer dent reed, because this is a 10 and I only have a 10 and an 8. It's pretty loose, but I really like how it is. But you know, I like to experiment to see how it comes out different ways. But I will wound on 3 yards of warp, and I'm nearing the end. Yeah, I think I've only got another couple of feet left. But it's very cool, and I can't wait to see how it turns out, and I'll show you later, maybe.